Welcome to Abu Dhabi Sustainability Week. This is the Transparency House. We have the honor to have Ms. Souad Al-Hosani.
It's my pleasure to see you again. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Okay, much welcome. Ms. Souad Al-Hosani is the head of investor care at the Abu Dhabi Investment Office. And she has also had previous roles with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. And she also had her own commercial career in the past. She had her own company.
But if on the level of the Abu Dhabi Investment Office.
So what is the Abu Dhabi Investment Office doing to promote innovation across all its activities? So what is the responsibility of the office and how do you promote innovation?
First of all, Andre, thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to be part of the Transparency House. As you mentioned, Abu Dhabi Investment Office helps support investments into the Emirate of Abu Dhabi. We remain committed to the innovation growth lead within the Emirate, as well as the diversification of the economy in the Emirate of Abu Dhabi. We also help investors and partner with investors from all sizes and all stages via providing them with incentive programs, and we help them expand into one of the Arab largest, second largest economies, as well as plug them in different markets. Nevertheless, the same Abu Dhabi Investment Office focuses and provides four main areas. Infrastructure partnerships, tech partnership, small medium enterprises, and direct investments.
There's a broad scope
of companies and parties that you're serving and working with.
Absolutely.
So almost across the whole Abu Dhabi society.
Absolutely. So basically, Abu Dhabi Investment Office works as the central governmental hub for the private sector within Abu Dhabi's government. So basically, we help facilitate the private sector needs in the expansion and exploring the market, as well as the investment opportunities within Abu Dhabi.
Mm-hmm. And about your own role as head of investor care, could you share a little bit more?
Absolutely. My role is very exciting. What we do is we do the whole A to Z process for investors looking to expand to the Emirates. We basically advise them on business establishment, requirements to expand. We explain to them the different laws, like the dual license. We promote to them the investment opportunities. We explain to them the difference between onshore and offshore. We help them with opening the doors with the government entities and explaining to them everything they need to expand in Abu Dhabi, as well as the incentives that the government entities offers to them.
Yeah. So how has it helped you? Because you had your own company in the past as well.
Absolutely.
And I can imagine now you deal with so many other companies in the private sector and the government sectors that sometimes two different worlds.
Absolutely.
So how did it help you in your current role to have been an entrepreneur?
Sure. Let me take a step back. Being an entrepreneur, whether it's a female or a male, does not make a difference as long as you look at the opportunities available out there and seek them. I would always say that I had the best days being an entrepreneur, and I'm even having my most amazing days today heading the investor care department within the Abu Dhabi Investment Office. The Abu Dhabi Investment Office role basically have helped me look at things from different perspectives. Coming from the private sector, helping companies in the past expand into the Emirate, knowing the difficulties investor faces and how to make it a better stream for investors to expand to the Emirate had helped me to succeed in my current role. So basically, when an investor comes facing difficulties, I know the way in and out. I would explain to him the best ways to expand. I would inform him about the ways to perform a better business within the Emirate, and so on. So I think both the private sector and public sector had added to me as a person, and I'm really happy to serve and be part of the Abu Dhabi Investment Office team.
Wonderful.
And if you look back, because now you're there where you are now in your current role, and you have some wide experiences and roles already.
Yes.
Now, if you think of young women in Abu Dhabi, in the UAE,
yes.
What would you have for them? What if you were at that point, how did you look to your own future, and what advice do you have?
I think 10 years ago, the opportunities for SMEs were less than today. I think Abu Dhabi government have supported a lot of SMEs through a lot of programs available out there via accelerator programs, youth hubs, and much other opportunities. I think even access to financing have become easier for SMEs today. So what I would advise entrepreneurs to do is to explore the markets around the world, look at new technologies technologies, have innovation as the core aspect of their business, try to expand the business within the Emirate, obtain the opportunities, take the risks. If you don't take risks, I don't think there is nothing going to be successful, but taking risk is one of the most important part of being a successful entrepreneur. Also, networking is very important. Meeting people, building relationships, attending events will also help you develop a great business.
Yeah. So you would encourage
young people, women and men, and Absolutely. Young men to start Absolutely. Their own business?
Absolutely. There is no way to stop. I always say, and I will remain saying that, why not, if you have the ability and the capability and the opportunities and all these incentives available for you to open a business and to expand?
If you compare the
opportunities you get as a woman or as a young man in that case, do you think it's more difficult as a human to open your business and start your business in the UAE, or is it different?
No, it's all the same. I think whether it's a female, whether it's a male, I think we through our amazing leadership, have excellent opportunities for whether you're a male or a female entrepreneur. I think I was able always to achieve what I wanted. I always had the support from the government and the leadership, and there is nothing that ever stopped me to reach where I wanted to be.
So do you see
yourself as a typical power woman or as a normal professional like anybody else?
I think it's a combination. So I think being a strong woman is one of the characteristics, but I wouldn't say name myself as a powerful woman. I think it's the experience I have gained from my entrepreneurship background and now within the government have reached me and helped me to be where I am today.
Yeah. Well, this is really amazing, and I think it's an example that careers can have different paths even. And the entrepreneurship experience is even very useful for
Absolutely.
If you move to the government side.
Absolutely.
So we're so grateful to have you here today to share this.
It's my pleasure.
And so this is Souad Al-Hosani of the Abu Dhabi Investment Office in the Women Leadership part of the Transparency House.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So